And we're back for game two in a best of three. It's Invictus Gaming versus Vici Gaming. You're watching the Summit Asia Playoffs, of course, powered by Twitch. I'm LD, joined here by Guts.
Those guys?
Yeah. Good. That was smooth.
How are you, LD?
I'm good. I almost pointed directly up at the Twitch sign. Mm-hmm. I got my hands mixed up again, but it's okay.
I'm not Twitch. That's not my name. That'd be a cool name.
But yeah, with that being said, it's game one, or game two of a best of three. In game one, yep. We saw IG a little sloppy, but they outplayed Vici. They had a good start in the laning stage. 430 went ham with four kills off the bat, and well, they took game one.
Yeah, I think a lot of that was IG strategy, making it not look as dominant as. I mean, at the end they got sloppy. I agree there, but I think mid game it was just like IG had no way to push towers while Vici Gaming did. So even though IG had a better start, IG couldn't really defend towers, couldn't really push towers. So Vici Gaming clawed back in with some tower gold, but end game IG were just too strong. Part of that being the dire side Roshan as well, I think.
Yeah, and the team fights just were much better for IG. They got the jump on the supports in that last team fight near the Roche pit, and game kind of fell apart from there, but it's time now for game two. Winner of this match moves on to play LGD today, so with that being said, the draft's underway. Let's get into it. Game two, IG versus VG. Here we go. This is the part where you load the draft bracket.
You're giving him so much time, so much cues now.
He's busy moderating the chat. That's why he's late.
Yeah. What? Okay, Brian, what did he do that need to be banned for? Fill us in. So
he's rare begging.
Rare begging.
That's an offense punishable by death.
All right. Well. Okay. All right.
Okay. Well, thank you, Brian, for holding down the chat. Can we test the game now? Oh. Okay. Cool. I don't know. I mean, if you're ready, if you're done moderating the chat, we'll move ahead with the broadcast.
Look, if you guys want to get unbanned, for those of you on the stream who have been wrongfully banned, tweet at kpoptosis,
yes,
and he will help you out.
kpoptosis. He would love to unban anyone and everyone.
Send any and all complaints towards kpoptosis.
You can also email him, kpoptosis@beyondthesummit.tv.
That's not his email, but...
I know.
We probably shouldn't
That's
be
not actually his email. I'm having mercy on you, Brian.
He'll give you his email if he wants you to.
A little mercy today. All right, game two. So I like the Centaur ban a lot from IG. That hero is ridiculously good, and they also are going to secure an Invoker with the first pick here. So a double whammy. Vici, Sand King's out there. He's been a premier support in the Chinese scene. Didn't have the biggest impact last game, but that was a very slow blink and just a very fat IG team.
It was a tough game for Sand King. Like, when you pick three cores, none of which are good team fight or initiating heroes like Vici Gaming did, it puts way too much pressure on your support.
You'd love to have like a Darkseer instead to combo with him, or the Centaur on your team.
I think that's the big thing that Vici Gaming are going to adjust here in game two. There's no and that's partly why IG banned out the Centaur, because they know they don't really want to first pick the Centaur when there's heroes like Invoker in the pool, potentially Batrider in the pool, although it did end up getting banned. So they ban it themselves to prevent that second two pick Centaur from Vici.
430 Invoker. The pianist.
Yeah.
The pianist has returned.
It may not be. Like, Luo's
played
this hero a lot.
No, give it to 430.
Look, man, we're going to...
Luo ain't no 430.
He's played some really good Exo Invokers. He's won IG a lot of matches in WPC as well as other tournaments, but it depends how the draft develops. If they can go for that strong mid-game... The thing that's nice about the safe lane Invoker is because, like, we're talking about these team fight controllers and initiators. Invoker is not really one of them. And that's where you want to have like a Ferrari puck in the mid lane and put Invoker safe lane, I feel. Not right off the bat. Like, I think you can play a Quas-Wex Invoker. You can still do Invoker mid if you get like a more traditional carry for Luo, but... Mm-hmm.
Yeah, Luo's been playing some unusual carries for the most part.
If they get the Darkseer for the offlane, then they don't really need a puck because they've got the Darkseer for the teamfight presence. So it depends a bit what they're going to get for the offlane for YYF. If they get a Darkseer, if they get... Nyx Assassin, then maybe they can do the Invoker mid for 430.
And I like this response from Vici, securing the Ancient Apparition and the Sand King. That is some serious pickoff potential. Profit the choice for IG. Yeah. Here come.
I think this is safe lane Invoker. I mean, it's not like it's still 50-50, but my thoughts is we're going to see it.
If that's the case, then I imagine Vici will just want to start banning tempo controllers, tanks, initiators, Dragon Knight, already banned out by IG. They could run offlane Prophet, solo mid Invoker is the other option, but we'll see.
This is just me on a hunch. Like, I could be completely wrong.
Your hunches have been good the past
few days. I make a bold statement. I think you want to ban the puck here if you're Vici Gaming, because puck's just fantastic as a tempo controller.
Who else is good here? Dragon Knight already banned. Yeah. Panda's the other one.
Oh, yeah. Ferrari plays a mean Panda. You could always do... that's another thing. You could do the Invoker mid with Panda safe lane. So I could be wrong, and then you do something like a safe lane farming Brewmaster. Brewmaster is so much fun to see lately. Every time I see him picked, it just puts a smile on my face.
Here come the emails for K-pop. I'm reading this chat right now. Yeah, I like the panda ban here, unless Vici want to pick it up for themselves. Yeah. Which, Super does play a nice panda of his own. It's just not a hero they've been favoring.
That's a hero Lua's played a bit of lately. If they do invoke a meta, they're not going to pick a hard carry for Lua. Like, I don't think this is where that's the mistake Vici made last time. I don't think you want to pick a Luna or a Weaver, a Lifesteal. Lifesteal is maybe kind of the borderline, but like the Wraith King type carry heroes are good. So we'll see what it's going to be here. But IG ban out Darkseer DK, so nothing too crazy with those bans.
Yeah, Wraith King's also the combo breaker. Like, you're running this Sand King Ancient Apparition, you just want to find a pickoff with those two. Not blow your whole load, and then Wraith King just respawns and goes for round two.
Yeah.
So we'll see what Vici follow this up with. In terms of offlaners, I was going to mention Darkseer Sand King, but he's been banned. So the Prophet's out of the pool, the Centaur's removed. There's still things like Clock, Bounty, who's really not very popular right now.
But Nyx Assassin's the other one, but...
So easy to zone out.
Yeah.
Offlane Nyx is just so easy to zone out.
I think the Radiant side is slightly better because you have it's a lot easier being creep experience range, but Dire side, I think you're more likely to see like a Clockwork type hero.
He's got the high armor and base regen, but if you're up against like 2-3 ranged heroes or just a bunch of lockdown, then he's not winning that matchup. They will go Lifestealer though, and they could still go aggressive. Sand King, Ancient Apparition plus one. Yep. Wraith King would have worked well for that type of tri lane. Let's see, who else is out there as far as ranged heroes go? Weaver is the other choice.
Mirana fits into every draft. Is
Where's
so damn powerful.
She has been ignored.
These teams not picking Mirana. I don't know why, but I mean, it's not like a must pick here, but it's definitely to me like a tier one pick every single game. If you
safe pick,
yeah. 10 seconds. And you talk about the offensive trial, and I think it works really. They could still do like Lifesteal like as a solo hero, depending what IG get.
Yeah, and run the aggressive trial. Yeah.
Lifesteal 1v1 against Prophet's just fine. He goes like Stout Shield, gets pulled some Tengos. He can go Stout Shield plus Quelling Blade and get pulled Tengos and do just fine that lane.
Yeah, if Prophet gets boots first and gets his phase boots first, then he'll be fine, but Lifesteal is not going to die.
I really like the AA Mirana like offensive trials, like the Team Dog style. Yeah. They do it with a Rubick where it's a bit stronger.
Or Bane, once in a while Shadow Demon. Yeah. But yeah, it is very strong. Sandcade's a bit weaker in that regard. Not sure what else they could do, really. That's kind of their best play right now, I feel.
Dazzle. This is like, I mean, this draft right now has push ridden all over it with Invoker, Exord Invoker, with like going for the minions, the Necrobook army, the Nature's
heals.
Prophet. Yeah.
Luna's still out there as well for a pushing carry.
Yep.
Might be a bit too greedy, though.
It's where they have zero team fight between
They could go Quaswex, Invoker, and Luna if they want.
I think if they go Luna, they almost need to go Quaswex.
She's slightly weak against Lifestealer or against these tri lanes in general, depending on the matchup. Like, if you have that Mirana tri-lane, it's so easy to just blow.
You know what
the
they can go, which Lewis played quite a bit of?
What?
Goes well with the Dazzle.
What?
Has a set that's bundled with our tournament.
The Chopmaster?
The Chopmaster, yeah. I think it'd be good here. That's a good Lua hero. Lua doesn't always... like, he'll play these heroes which aren't really carries sometimes, so... Good against Lifestealer, you can argue?
I like Axe here. I think Axe would be good.
Is it... Vici game like the only team who still run Alchemist.
Super Alchemist. Here we go.
Mean, every time, I honestly don't think they've actually been that successful with Alchemist. They're the only team who still plays it, and they play it mid and normally to pretty good success. But there's no Chopmaster. It's a weird.
I like it better when you're Radiant because you can stack the Ancients easier. Yeah. You can even just Acid Spray from the low ground, aggro the Ancients, and stack them.
There was one game he did that, and he did so well. And every time since then, I've seen him play Radiant Alchemist. He stopped doing it. I don't know why, but. It was so, like, one game he had, like, a 7-minute mech using the Ancient Stacking. But Weaver for IG, so... this is just, like, a Weaver...
This
safe
is a tough
Weaver,
game for
Prophet.
Weaver, honestly. Like, once Sankey gets a blink and Alk stun, you just dust him when he's Sakuching away, and he's
this IG draft went from exciting to pretty vanilla with this Weaver pick.
I don't feel like it has huge synergy with the Invoker Prophet.
They could still do Chuan support Axe is still possible. Like Chuan played Axe recently. When we had our GeoGuessr night, we saw him play some Axe. I remember we got a game of that.
There was a lot more GeoGuessr and a lot less watching of Dota for me that night.
Well, it was when the GeoGuessr ended.
Oh, okay.
By then we weren't in the best state to remember the Dota. Maybe
it all just kind of floated on by.
The GeoGuessr was more memorable.
Well, the one concern for Vici is they're running a triple melee draft here, so...
Yeah, that's like Axe's dream come true.
Yeah, that's even more reason to go Axe. And IG running four ranged heroes, so... Yeah.
Doom.
Quad melee.
Ooh. Doom can offlane, I guess, or Lifesteal can also offlane, so we'll see what VG Gaming prepares. I don't think they want to go offensive tri-lane.
They're going to have a double melee lane no matter what. So
I think they have to go, and then Sanking wants levels and farm, so I think they almost have to go safe lane, tri-lane. Lifestealer does more with the farm, so I think you do Lifestealer safe lane with Doom offlane.
Doom offlane on the Dire is quite weak, though.
Yeah.
Don't have easy access to the big camp.
It's like one of those let's ditch the lane as soon as possible and go jungle kind of lanes.
And their dual lanes are bad, too. Like, what's the dual lanes here? Doom, Ancient Apparition.
I don't really like the
Lifestealer, Ancient Apparition.
Every offlane was banned. Clockwork and Nyx both got banned out towards the end there, so it was just a bounty hunter left in the pool as far as your.
This could. What VG. If they abandon the offlane, IG can just be. Get some greedy support here, maybe like even an Enigma, Chen, and just get so much out of the woods. And Weaver will free farm the safe lane, so IG can really outgreed Vici as far as I'm concerned, and come out on top through the laning stage.
Yeah. Well, we saw some Chuan dunks last game with the Earthshaker. Let's see some Axe dunks. Oh, it's a Lion. It's still a good pick here. It's
okay. These heroes have a lot of just gap closing and burst damage.
It's a tricky game to play Lion, but if you
play it well, it can be very strong.
It's like the Hex Lifesteal before he gets his Rage off and you initiate in kind of Lion. But we talk about, like, last game it was tough for the Vici Gaming supports. Like, they were the ones controlling the teamfight. It's the same thing here. Unless we're seeing Quazwex Invoker, which I think we might just based on the three cores IG have. Like, it's all up to the Lion in this teamfight. He's the only disable. So I think this is, like, most certainly a Quazwex Invoker. They haven't got good setup for Sunstrakes and other lanes either, so I think you need to go for Quazwex this game if you're Invoker. And also against these melee heroes, Quazwex is just so damn annoying and can cripple their mana pools.
Yeah, I like Quazwex this game quite a bit as well. Who's going to get Arcanes on Vici? It's maybe Doom, Sand King, that's about it.
Yeah.
Ancient Apparition generally just goes for the value point booster.
Yeah.
I do feel a bit squishy, though. If Vici get through the laning stage intact, that is just a big old death ball coming their way. And a lot of tanky heroes, a lot of aggressive face rush style heroes from Vici. I'm a bit worried for them if they don't do much in this laning stage.
Yeah, I think
they should excel here with 5 ranged heroes against 1.
It does feel like the first 5-10 minutes of the games is going to be important for Vici Gaming to get ahead with the Sanking A8 potential ganks coming out. So
they have boots on FYA level 1. Yep. He'll head into the enemy jungle. He's been pulled a single observer. Probably just wants to slow down the jungle a bit for YYF if he goes there.
He's going to be running ASAP down there to get that ward. So this means Doom... Is Doom even going to go straight jungle and put Sanking offlane? Like, that's a bit... It's unconventional, but maybe something we'll see happen.
IG have Impale to cancel Sandstorm shenanigans. Yeah. They have Tornado. They have the Heal Bomb if the creep wave is near him. I don't think he can do anything too cheeky with Sandstorm.
No. You can do the let's hide in the trees, like down here. just leech experience without your opponents realizing, but that's one of those little annoying tricks you can do. All right, I'm getting a...
K-pop's giving you some verbal commands here.
Sorry.
Here we go. IG versus Vici, game number 2. Currently, IG leading the set 1-0. A win here means they've got a date with LGD today. Right after this best of 3, a loss, and we'll go to a deciding game 3. You're watching the Summit, powered by Twitch, the Asia region, from which only one team will advance and qualify. Come here to LA, fight for over $105,000 on LAN at the Beyond the Summit studio home. We'll have stretch goals announced soon, but for now, let's get into game 2. Fenrir, playing your Ancient Apparition, Super the Alchemist, that leaves Sylar as the safe lane Lifestealer. ROTK going to the offlane as the Doom, and then playing that support Sanking will be FY. Dropped a nice Observer Ward here, and... With that being said, their opponents, IG, they're up 1-0, gods.
Well, my boys, IG, we got YYF playing the safe lane farming Nature's Prophet. It's going to be Ferrari 430. Is going Exalt build in the mid lane, and this is because they've set up an offensive trial lane. They want to get aggressive. Chuan on the line, Faith on the Dazzle, and finally, Weaver being played by Luo. So they want to shut down this Lifestealer farm. And it's not so much Lifestealer as a scary carry. It's like, why not? You've got triple range heroes against a Lifestealer, so you can go this offensive trial lane, especially with an Exalt Invoker on your team to provide the Sunstrikes to help out.
You know your heroes are weak when the enemy can go aggressive tri-lane with Lion.
Yeah.
And Lion is not an aggressive tri-lane hero, but 3 ranged heroes and Sunstrike and 4 melees on Vici, they're not going
to
be able to do
much. Also to punish the Sanking support, who's not good at fighting tri-lane versus tri-lane early on. So Sanking says, screw this, I'm going bottom, and wants to try and maybe find an early kill on YYF.
There is a Radiant Observer Ward here, so they should have spotted him making this move. And
I think they did. There
playing
was no
it
smoke,
pretty safe.
So...
Yeah, he didn't have smoke, so they definitely saw
it. And, like, you go in with the Barrow Strike, YYF can just insta-TP after the Barrow Strike hits. And he's going to be pretty much full HP for this gank.
Yeah,
so
unless you go for that value level 2 Doom, but that is quite unusual. Top lane, Sylar dropping pretty low here. One more right click. Sunstrike, not picked up yet. 430 on the level 2.
Yeah, it's Salve and two Tengos already gone, so this is... That's Sylar. He's zero CS and used up all this regen. That's really the really bad thing. He's not even trading regen for last hits. He's just trading regen to stay in this lane for XP.
They'll rotate a support out. They say, you know what? We can take this lane 2v2. Weaver Dazzle against Lifestealer, H Apparition. We're not going to lose this, and yep. They're right about that. They can also shut down FY, keep the safe lane farmer in good shape, and 430 can win mid as Exort Invoker against a melee hero. So they could potentially win all three lanes on the side of IG. I am quite worried against Vici.
Especially with this smart little... They re-sentried the pull at top lane. So it got dewarded, and then they come in, put another sentry down, and deward the Vici Gaming sentry. So this is permanently blocked. Unless Vici Gaming want to invest in more sentries, this safe lane is going to be a real struggle for them. And Fenrir's done just that. He's bought more sentries. That's really when you know you're struggling. It's the only thing they can do. Like, Lifesteal's not going to farm unless they pull the weight back under his tower. So Fenrir's bought more sentries just for this.
Nice body blocking by YYF, surrounding ROTK while in the trees. Oh, FY Burrow strikes through, tries to go for the first blood on Chuan. He does have a hex. He's waiting for the last second. But FY can still... Oh, no. He's the haste. Where's the move speed? He's actually getting run into the trees a bit here. One more right click. No, the first blood. There you go. FY secures it. The stun coming out from the Alchemist. They're looking for the two for it on special. Fiji, not the best in lanes, but what's the best solution to that? Don't lane.
Wow.
Just roam.
A bit lucky with a haste rune of all things. Like, that's the only rune that makes that happen there. But
and it's a support lion, a squishy, low armor hero.
That was unfortunate for IG. A bit of bad luck. As far as we look at top lane, Lua's actually in trouble. There's a sensual down. Lua goes down to the AA. That chilling touch damage, and Weaver got left alone
they
there.
They TP'd the Dazzle out, but he just played it like he had a dual lane.
And that's where bringing in those extra sentry wards. He uses one to deward the pull and the other to help get that kill, so...
Well, some bad luck with the haste rune bottom, coupled up with over-aggression from the Weaver, and the end result is just trouble for IG.
Weaver was not expecting there to be so much detection. He knew that like multiple sentry wards had been used on the pull. He was not expecting there to be more sentries and or dust for the lane. Like, that was
well, but
really...
they saw this get dewarded.
Yeah.
So he knew there was at least one extra sentry possible.
No, he almost Shikuchi out of the range there, but yeah, it was... Well, we are going to see... I don't know. Lua goes right back top lane, and we'll be with his that Ring of Aquila probably doing pretty... They're still winning this top lane.
And 430's 19 and 15 red.
Oh, gosh.
Exort Invoker against an average melee hero. Not a fun experience for the melee hero, but no, this is a
You think Exort Invoker, and you think you want to be ganking this guy early, and there's just no room. Vici Gaming are under so much pressure in top and bottom lane that Invoker's going to have free farm for days in mid lane.
RTK does hit level 5, so Doom's coming soon, and there's some food heroes this game. Level 3 Dazzles, potentially food. They'll find FY a regen rune. Right on the Tron, he'll go. He's got the Burrow Strike at the ready. It's only level 1, but with the boots, he can run him down here. He's in range. He'll set that up as their follow-up from Super. They needed the body block. He didn't get in front of him.
Well, they both have boots. Chuan does not. Chuan's going to have to turn and impale at some point.
Get him the vision. Then he can follow up with the stun. It's going to land on Chuan. Almost kills him instantly. The follow-up's here, though. Four heroes arrive from IG and say, you've taken our Chuan. We're taking you with us.
Shadow Wave group up for this Shadow Wave bomb.
Sunstrike's also ready, but it's not even needed.
They're gathering for the bomb. That is such a painful death.
Yeah, had no mana, had nothing to do but die.
Four hero Shadow Wave.
They also had Sunstrike, but that is the easier kill.
Yeah.
Save your mana.
175 mana, screw that.
Fire's plus, like it's more entertaining.
Yeah.
We haven't had a BTS moment in a while. I think
we've been slacking.
Mini moment worthy.
Yeah.
But yeah, 430. He's beast moding mid.
He is. He's
carrying his team once again.
20. He's the Doom's actually top CS at the bottom lane. So RTK should expect it. Probably see like an Arcane Boots mech out of him this game. I think. Actually, normally the Alchemist goes mech, so maybe he's going to go for like a Phase Drums or an Arcane Boots Drums.
Sylar. He just got healed for around the trees. Well. Oh, man. Oh, these heals are...
They may find Fenrir as well. They do find Fenrir. They just dive him. Like, unless Sanking's here, and even if Sanking is here, Fenrir is... Like, he can't be under this tower.
Vici are getting run over by Invictus Gaming. Yep. They are not looking good right now.
And with the Ring of Aquila, this tower should go down here, I think. The next creep wave coming in needs to be cleared out, but...
Yeah, they can also draw it off the tower, pull it into this camp here, but they're not going to do it. In comes your teleport. It's the Lifestealer, Sylar. Not the easiest hero to bring down from full HP. Meanwhile mid, FY. Here we go.
This is not going to be the easiest kill. TP from the Lion.
Triple TP, and they're still committing to it. They could have just ran away, but now FY on the run. Probably going to be brought down super hexed up as well. He sprouted to the Sunstrike. Slightly off the mark on FY. Still, though, Super's going to make it out, potentially.
They couldn't make up their mind. Like, two heroes went for super, two went for the Sanking. If everyone went for super, he dies. If everyone... I think Sanking maybe was going to get it regardless, but the Invoker going for super, not going for super was a bit of a mistake there, but...
And they forced... That's a triple TP. That's as good as a kill in terms of gold. That is 300... Actually, it's 405 gold, I believe. So, yeah. Pretty nice. That's a pair of boots for your team.
Yeah. Does keep Ferrari's early minus hopes and dreams alive, but...
Gives the Lifestealer space, gives the Doom some breathing room. Yep. That is the definition of a space-created move. Phase and bottle up now for the Doom. So it looks like he will be going for more of the carry Doom build.
He's smoked up. He's hit level 7 now, and he's going to be looking for a kill. And I think they realize this Invoker is just free farming way too much. So they're gunning towards Invoker mid with this gank.
Has not skilled anything yet with... he has. My math is not strong right now. They'll find 430. They look for the Doom. Just a Burrow Strike to follow this up. It should be a pretty easy kill.
Maybe not. Price tanky.
They're committing to this one. The Alk Stun gets lobbed in from downtown. Super delivers. And 430. The Doom should take him down here. Is there a deny available by Faith? He gets off the deny.
That's
beautifully played.
That's crazy timing. Like, getting that's really tricky. Super luckily, his Haste Ring is going to keep him alive as he runs towards the top river. But timing that deny as the grave wears off.
Oops. Oh, missed the Sanking dying on the...
It was a Shadow Wave bomb, yeah.
Yeah, I think the heal just killed him off.
So, IG, they lose the Invoker there, but it's a Doom cooldown. They get the counter kill and the Sanking. It's still a small victory for VG Gaming, but talked about last time it was space created for VG Gaming's life and whatnot. Weaver was farming top, YWF's farming and pushing bottom lane, so this time around it's IG getting some space for their other core heroes.
And they've left the Lifestealer alone. Yeah, he can infest creeps, he can stay alive, but he is under a little bit of duress now with the Weaver hitting level 6.
Yeah. Silo has done fantastic, though, to catch up and actually go well ahead of the Weaver in CS. 37 CS, the Weaver's 28.
And the Doom 40. That was a Doom against a defensive tri lane at first.
Yeah. Well, bottom tier 1 tower under deny range here, and it's not going to get denied. Goes down to the Siege creep, and YYF will get out of there okay.
Oh, mid lane, they've gone in a 430 again. He's overextended in the mid river, and one right click will bring him down.
That's your life steal with TPing. Like, VG Gaming.
They even have a ward here on the hill.
That's just good teamwork coordination. Like, Super says, look, this guy's gone way too far forward. TP now, and he'll die to my stun. So.
You know what it really is? It's the Alk stun. That thing is just like a bomb coming from across the map.
Yeah. Even after the big nerfs, it's still...
Still ridiculous.
It's still his best spell, really.
Now there's Doom online here. They could go on Luo. They're not going to go for it. He had two heroes coming in, but Alex not to. Little surprised they didn't try for something. Siler will initiate the final YWF here. Open wound. Level 2. They'll start it off on the Prophet. The Rage comes out. The Burrow Strike's available. They're reserving the Doom for a second kill. And Luo says, sorry, bub.
Luo thought about Shikuchi and he's like, wait a second. That's a Doom.
That's
Doom. No thanks.
I'm a little worried for IG. They have food supports. Lion is food, level 4. Faith, not so much. He's level 6, but they can just Doom him. No grave for you, sir. And 5 heroes, no tanky frontliner like a Centaur. They've got to be very careful about their positioning. And we haven't even seen Lifestealer bombs. We haven't even seen Ancient or Chenault involved yet. But they can throw that into the mix soon.
Yeah. Well, we'll see where this is just really nice from VG Gaming. Like, Ferrari had that really good early start. And they say, look, we need to kill this guy at least a couple times to slow down. He would have had like a 7-8 minute Midas. Now it's 9, almost 10 minutes in, and he's still 500 gold short. So... They focus and shut down the right heroes at the right time. Like, you give Invoker a good early start, it's not the end of the world, assuming you then pressure him around this 8-9 minute mark.
And I'm sure the call from Super was, guys, I think I'm losing my lane. This guy's 15 denies at 4 minutes. Yeah. Well, they turned that one around. ROTK going to find a Haster, and he's bottled up. They can't burst him down. They just need to get out, maybe bait some TPs, but they are not killing this Doom.
That was a smoke towards the mid lane that they were attempting.
ROTK is going to rush in. I don't think he can do much here either.
No.
There's 4 heroes mid. Better just to go farm and install. They force out the Haster, though, which is kind of nice.
And Fenrir, he's level 6 now as well, so this is actually really tricky for IG. They can't push it all. They just want to go for those smoke ganks like we just saw, but the problem is Doom was in the right place to deflect that one.
Nice Dire Observer Ward spotting Tron's movement through the jungle with the Ancient Apparition ult online. There's some kill potential here. Faith will make his own move top, and in comes RTK. This will be an easy kill on the Weaver if they find him. The Courier comes in and scouts him out just in the nick of time. The Dazzle as well, giving them the vision.
Yeah, trying to get that Doom from Fog before the Shikuchi, but...
Not going to find it.
This is I like the rotation from ROTK. Bottom lane at this point is a pretty dangerous place to be farming until it pushes really close to the tower. And when it does, Fenrir's there. I mean, he doesn't need the levels or the farm. He's actually like already got level 6, even level 7, but...
They're stacking for super as well. I like the movements from Vici. This is a stack that you can easily kill with level 4 acid spray.
Oh, FY's good as Blink 2 now. He's just hit the 2.1k gold mark.
This is a good timing window. Inchat Brishnolt coming in top. They TP in the Alchemist. They'll doom up Faith, but he's already walking away. The tower denied by the Lifestealer. Now the TP comes in from the Nature's Prophet. YYF trying to bail his buddy out. Alk stun is going to connect. Nails Faith. He's dropping low. The Doom's wearing off soon. They got to finish Faith if they want to go on him. One more right-click Rage. Sylar getting juked a bit. He does still get the kill, but does he have an access point to retreat? Stick charge is ready. Eight. No, the Sunstrike's going to clip him, and down he goes.
Just barely, though. Invoker now minus up as well following that. Well, not that that one contributed towards it. But
they did get the tower deny, and they get a one-for-one, but they're giving up a carry for support.
They
not ideal.
They dive so hard for that kill and dazzle there. Not worth it at all in the sense that, like, they could have just got the tower deny and backed off.
Still, Vici are very strong right now. With the Blink on Sand King, level 6 on HR Apparition, they are ready to
fight. In a bit of trouble. Lewis chasing him down hard. And
that's a level 3 Scorched Earth.
Yeah, about to say, there's no stuns to back this one up. Prophet didn't TP in or anything. I mean, Prophet couldn't have got the kill regardless. Prophet, speaking of which, does have his minus now. So double minuses for IG. It's catch-up time for IG. They don't want to really fight too much. They just want to be the counter-initiators, I guess. But
yeah, Vici are happy in either scenario. With a Blink on Sand King, they can counter-initiate or they can start the fights.
IG's counter-initiation is just really weak in general. Bottom line, though, Chuan is he's done so.
That's half his health! It's Vivek!
What? Oh, there's a push mid. He bought back just for this push, which is...
All they used was an Alk stun and Enchant Apparitional. I guess with the Enchant Apparitional down, though, it is. But his buyback doesn't get them this tower. They already had the tower.
Yeah, I'm not sure.
That is debatable.
It's a very weird buyback. It was just a 330 gold one, so it does just give them that bit of a safety net for the push, but...
Unless they're going for two.
I don't think it was a rage buyback. I think he thought that went through, but end result, it wasn't needed. So it was a wasted buyback, but I don't think it was a rage buyback.
You never know with Tron. He does get angry. Yeah. I saw him at TI2 after they lost the game at the play. They'll find the Weaver here on the backside, gets doomed. HM Apparitional coming to him, pops him. What was he doing? He was just like trying to be cute and clever and Sakuchi all around behind the tower and ran through somebody, gave them vision, and now the medallion. Ooh. Oh, this is Roche.
That's why they give Fenrir that farm bottom lane. So fast medallion for Vici, and with Doom to tank, with Acid Spray, with Lifesteal's Deeps, you can...
This is a Roche secured. Unless Vici take a really sloppy engage, but
yeah,
they have the medallion, the minus armor from Acid Spray, Lifestealer who can give the team max open wounds so they heal up during the Roche attempt. This is a very good Roche lineup.
There's still all the IG tier ones up, so they are actually... They can always be in close proximity should they scout it out, but scouting it out when, like, three Vici gaming heroes can take Roche on their own is tricky to do.
I like this play from YYF. TP's on the hill, drops the ward, and TP's out.
It helps when you're like trying to figure out if your opponents are roaching a ward like this, because you know they're not in their jungle. You're thinking, okay, they're either smoked up or roaching at this, like, at some point. So just getting as much offensive vision as possible. Like, they've got wards all throughout the enemy jungle right now.
Enchant Apparitional will come in. It's headed directly towards the top lane, while three heroes from IG wrap around from behind. They might be too late to get to this fight. Lifestealer diving Sylar. Oh, he's forced to back off. This could be good. FY, gotta get out of vision here. Has to find the good counter-initiate. He's lurking on the backside. The swarm comes in. Luo, giving chase. FY, they do have an infest ready. If they want to counter-gank this, they can do so. But there's a Radiant Observer ward. It's spotted them out, and the Doom just gonna hoof it out of there. Or is he gonna run back in?
He's got haste still.
Ooh. Not enough. Good attempt, though, from IG. Yeah. That could have been a big mistake for Vici. They did not have out for that.
RTK really pushing the limits. That was like some... That was some RTK-type play there. Like, sometimes
if this was Quas Wax Invoker, you just get tornadoed, and that haste gets purged, and down you go.
I'm really surprised he didn't go Quas Wax this game. I feel like it would have been a much stronger play. Oh, so why we have TP'd in for an Observer Ward bottom lane? He may be
this
in trouble.
This one, not so lucky. Super's ready. He's on the hunt. The Lifestealer comes in as well, and...
Oh, and they know it's water. They have the sentry there for it.
It's already there, in fact. The sentry was dropped down first.
I don't know if they actually saw him TP for the ward, though, and it did create space to push down top, but...
It's like, why else
immediate hex on
there,
Super? Super may just die.
He's the mech carrier, though. He can pop this mech, pops the ult, potentially still alive for now. In comes the Bro Strike Epicenter, being channeled by FY, brings the Invoker low, hasn't killed him off. Fate's gonna spread to the winds.
TP
it's the Delta split. Oh, one more right click. One more right click. Right click him already. The Doom. Onto Luo, but he's used to Kochi. FY forced to give chase. Well, they managed to bring down Faith. Sylar's still in pursuit. They're going to try and clean him up. They barely bring down Luo. They also find Faith. They will clean up three in the end.
Sunstrike in five. FY is trying to juke, but there's an Observer Ward. This juke's not working with the Observer Ward there. Oh, the Prophet Ultimate.
Who needs Sunstrike?
YYF.
Do it the easy way.
Yeah.
Poor guy.
That was really good for IG, though, I feel. Even though they lost the Weaver there in the end, they didn't get the tier 2 tower. They managed to just get some really nice kills. I think
Sylar got juked so hard. Yeah. He, like, ran in here. He's like, wait, where's the Dazzle? Runs back out. The Dazzle just retreats out and
they had a
almost ends up
the Dazzle TP'd out just barely, and then the Invoker as well got graved and TP'd. So.
No. The Dazzle actually went down.
Yeah, yeah. The Invoker got the grave TP off and...
The Lion made it out, I believe. The Lion was the support.
Yeah. One of the supports survived with a TP. I guess that was Chuan.
Yeah, it was Chuan.
Really, like, IG, that could have gone a lot worse for him. In the end, they trade, like, kind of evenly on kills and get some clutch kills themselves.
Well, that sounds nice, but not if they keep on giving up kills elsewhere on the map. Faith, caught by the HF, original, chop down. Chuan will be next. Is... No running for Chuan. No hiding for Chuan. Unless the tree trap.
He gets
now the phase boots.
Oh, Blink Barrier Strike coming out. Chuan now locked in place. Super's going to have another Sunstream. The Sunstrike going to be hitting on top of Alchemist. Nice play by Ferrari getting that kill. Fenrir's taking a lot of damage from the Forward Spirits being pushed out of this lane. Meanwhile, the Sand King sprouted up, has Burrow Strike available.
Oh, he whiffs on the Burrow Strike.
Chuan's
he's a bit
still alive.
Chuan has no disables, though, for 5 seconds time. Blinking forward. They've got to finish him off with a right click. Don't do it with Sylar. But they've lost quite a few. Doom arrives. No Doom yet. In the Sandstorm they go. They've got Doom soon, though. This could be bad for IG if they overextend. And the Sand King...
Sand King gets out of there. He TP'd home, so...
What a... A chaotic game, but hey, Alchemist for Lion was
Chuan lived that long was pretty impressive.
This is Exhort and Invoker for you, though. Sure, maybe not as much crowd control, but they are not getting these kills with Quasquex. He is dishing out some serious hurt.
Yep. Luo desperately needs to finish off his Lincolns, though. He's struggling for his farm. Throwing down a casual weave in the secret shop.
Here comes the smoke. They have the they have the Shadow Blade as well. Good timing for Vici to get aggressive. If they get some kills here, that will be Roche.
Yeah, they got this early medallion.
Clean kills, and that's an easy Roche.
And even without the Roche, medallion just synergizes nicely with the Alchemist.
FY channeling the Epi, he's found Faith. Oh, they had the vision.
He almost saw it in time for the self-grave.
The funny part was he channeled it from the low ground.
Yeah.
Like, Dazzle even saw him, and he's like, wait, what do I do here?
He could have insta-grave, but I think he dies regardless to an Ice Blast. Chuan at mid now. Caught out as well, so IG just giving away freebie after freebie. The supports, it's so hard for them to stay alive here. Super could be set for a Sunstrike. Where's the Sunstrike? He's trapped in a Sprout here. Ferrari shows up. No Sunstrike just yet. There it's going to come. Super gets blown to pieces. Ferrari. Exod and Voke are going to get doomed up now here. That's problematic for him. RFDK wants this kill. Looks like he'll pop the drums. He's going to die for this kill, and he will.
Diving against the Forge Spirits. They just really underestimate the damage output. And then on the side of the fight, Luo, he's been Burrow Strike, but continues the chase. A few more right clicks to bring him down. Time lapses out.
He's committing. He wants Fenrir. He can get Fenrir. One right click and...
Down he goes.
No mana for Burrow Strike.
Crawling their way back into this game. Vici are just not respecting the Forge Spirits. They are diving under tower, tanking multiple Forge Spirit shots, and not only do they hit hard, but they reduce your armor by one with every auto attack, and these heroes not long for this world against that.
The Doom looked the Doom's gone Shadowblade. I only just noticed that now, and that's partly why he was so squishy in that fight. Like, he's diving the Invoker there. I'm thinking, okay.
He could have a Plate Mail and then some.
Yeah, if he had the Plate Mail, or, I mean, even like a normal Doom items like your mech, sure, the Alchemist has got it, so you're not going to go to the mech as well, but... even a pipe or something.
There's a Blink Barrel mid. They will catch out Faith. He's going to grave immediately. Tanks the stun in the face. He's dead.
Throw a weave, throw a check. Oh, they lose Luo as well in the middle.
Running for YYF. Trying to bring out YYF. RTK going for yet another kill. He'll have a nice Shadow Blade right click. He needs to have a level death here as well. One more right click. The level death and another. He brings him down. It's three dead. It's the pianist who's next. No ghost walk. No fancy fingers for you. Just death and destruction. 430. That's four dead. And Vici bounce back.
Yeah. They're going to get... possibly their first tower of the game. That's a scary thing. Like, Vici Gaming are fighting and are ahead without a single tower. They're only 2 to 3k gold ahead because they have no tower money, but once these towers start falling, Vici Gaming will get very scary quickly.
They are good at chasing as well. Doom with Shadowblade drums, Sankey with Blink. You cannot overextend against this lineup.
And ROTK actually using drum charges, unlike what we saw Mushi doing the other day.
Yeah.
Ends the game at like 60 minutes in and has 5 drum charges.
Yeah, amazing how he's just like popping them like they're candy.
Yeah. I think it's the right way to do it.
I would rather see them overused than underused. Yeah. Ultimately, it's an early game item that, drum charges are nice late, but you can just win a game early with some good drum charges.
Yeah. We'll see maybe Vici go into Roshan now. They got DD rune on Super, but still not too confident. They've got decent map control. They've got Observer Wards, Sentries at Roshan at mid lane as well. Deep Observer Wards at the top lane and mid lane. Right now, Vici's
that was like fantastic wards.
It's fantastic. Yeah, they see everything from IG.
All of them dropped off of at least these two dropped on the back of a good team fight. That's what you see from really good support players is, sometimes you just go for like a smoke solo ward. We saw Fluff used to do that a lot. But normally you win a team fight, you immediately go ward the enemy jungle, you get deep wards down in the lanes, and you prepare for the next engagement.
Yeah. As much as wards can be game-changing, I don't know if using smokes to get wards down is
Smokes are a resource, too. Sylar, he gets off a rage in time! Chuan slow on the trigger finger here, now he's gonna just take some right-clicks in the face! Epicenter's coming! FY delivers, he only finds one, though. And is that enough, is the question?
Chuan's still alive!
The finger thrown up by Chuan, he's gonna live through it all! Heads in the trees, has no TP scroll, though. He looks to be dead. Faith, one more right-click.
Chuan, scat him,
still
though?
Hiding.
I don't know
still
if they scat
hiding.
Him.
I don't think they saw him.
Yeah, I think he was in fog when he went into those trees. So.
RTK's coming, though. He's got the Shadow Blade. 430 could be in trouble here. Is there gonna be a crit? Level death, he can cancel this TP, he can right-click him down! 430, no ghostwalk in time! Oh, that's just some bad luck.
Yeah.
They had no vision, didn't see the Doom coming, and walks right into the Invoker.
Well, good luck, Chuan. I think it's gonna be okay here.
Mm.
So, it's nighttime, they won't get vision.
Maybe he even goes for an epic backstep. I don't think IG are defending this. Oh, he's made his run! He's making his move now! It's Apparition all popping him!
Oh, he gets hit! He's dead!
Chuan.
He's donezo.
Where's the crit? The Tassel just leaves him.
Nah, the AA either ultimate would have lasted too long.
Yeah, but yeah. It was like right away that he TP'd out.
No.
I just love how Faith is like, I have no faith in you, Chuan. You're dead to me. Go think about your mistakes in the fountain.
They're giving up so many kills. They're giving up over 1 kill a minute this game. Like, it's uncharacteristic. IG are one of the more aggressive and kind of, like, they take more chances than a lot of the Chinese teams, but this game, just been feeding away kills left, right, and center to Sila, Super, and RTK. Even the supports!
I just can't believe Vici got through the laning stage. Their rotations were really clever and just well done. Because if they try to just lane against IG, they get crushed. But they just avoided the laning stage, basically.
So much of the game, like the early game, was decided by that Sanking Haste rune, though. That got Vici Gaming a double kill.
And then they still start giving up kills.
Yeah.
Which they would have done for sure if they didn't get the haste. Mm-hmm. But it was enough to get them through that stage.
Yep. We'll see what the plan's going to be from here on out for IG. They have that split push we saw last game from Prophet, but Prophet building an Orchid this game. So YWF going for a different kind of build. And now with Doom BKB, I love this pickup. This is the item RTK needs this game. So
yeah, we'll see AC next. If he gets that, good luck.
Yeah,
they have very little on a Doom with that much farm.
They've got double BKBs with Super and Doom. So
Doom when you go this build, you get the Assault Caress after this. You become the God of War. You're running at haste. You're 3 4-shotting supports. You can just disable one instantly with Doom. Yeah. If they don't have something that goes through BKB on you, you're unkillable.
It could even be the Shiva's Garb with Alchemist gain the AC. But
that's true.
Either
Shiva's
way,
or AC, but they kind of have the same punch.
Any bonus armor just makes him very that much more tankier.
Yeah, Weaver doesn't have Lincolns yet either. Man, he's really struggled.
Oh, yeah, this is...
The thing is, they can still just level death Doom him, but not having Lincolns means an Alk stun alone kills him.
Well, the feeds has been evenly distributed. Everyone on IG side has 4 to 6 deaths, so it has not been an isolated case of the feeds.
Yes, everybody's got a case of the feeds.
Well, for Vici Gaming, look at Vici Gaming. Everyone's got 5 kills. It's been perfect distribution there. Like, there's no one player from Vici Gaming say, they haven't really been that involved. Like, AA, it's only been 8 of the 26 kills, but...
By the way, interesting little spot from FY. Yeah, they've all been equally involved.
Yeah.
I don't know. They probably saw him jump up here with that observer.
I think he was scouting for observer. Like, they had the sentry. Like, the sentry's out of range, but...
He's still worming his way through the trees.
Yeah. From spot to spot.
So. Net has nothing on FY. I'm telling you, man.
Well, I don't know. I've seen Net be in trees long enough that he would get abandoned from MMR games. Or from just matchmaking in general.
Are you sure he wasn't just abandoning the game?
Maybe he was. Maybe he was AFK, but...
Okay.
He's been in trees for long times at a time. Meanwhile, Fenrir in the top jungle. Why are we going in for a solo kill on Fenrir?
Well, there's backup. They're ready for this. Sunstrike, they'll bring down Fenrir, but they're losing YYF.
He just... he TP'd for the ward. So he TP'd for the ward, found the AA.
No, they already had the ward down. That's how he saw him. He just TP'd in for the kill, but...
He had the...
They smoked top right before that.
And that's also a telltale sign. Like, he TP's in for that. Like, he's got a ward somewhere in your jungle, and AA just bought a gem, so that should be some easy D wards for... Faith once he respawns.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. He's still got in the stash.
Yeah,
okay.
It's on the courier.
I was like, wait, how's the gem not on the ground?
I think he'll take it himself and then just go into his jungle, check some vortexes down, find where these wards are, and then go. He doesn't even need to meet up with his team, so he can just throw ice blasts from anywhere.
I would like to see Vici fight with the sages. I think they're incredibly strong right now.
Yeah. The double BKB.
Oh, FY. Oh boy, if Flake through, he's gonna catch onto the Doom on the 430 right off the bat. They'll grave him, but where's he going? FY might go down here to the Ford Spirits. One more right click will secure the kill, but ROTK is cleaning up. Say hello to Mars. He really is the god.
Four for one. Killing the Sand King. The Necro 3s are pretty powerful at this stage, but they're not gonna win you the game. And Beachy Gaming, they're just rolling all over IG right now.
No mercy from ROTK Sama.
Finally, Lincoln's is up for Lua once he brings it out on the courier, but. Small things for IG. Meanwhile, VG Gaming are just whomping IG.
The Doom 7-1-7. The Lifestealer 6-2-6. And the supports, like you mentioned, are not doing poorly. They'll have an Axe not too soon on Fenrir, but like within the next 5 minutes if they keep it up. And
Super's done work on this Alchemist. He's been in more kills than anyone. Oh no, FY's done one upped him, but
they're just gonna be the Bash Bros. When VG dives you under your tower, you just run. You don't fight that. You don't try and counter-initiate, you just run and hope that they don't kill you during BKB and Rage. They've got triple magic immunity against a team with no proper lockdown.
Yeah. Oh dear. This is where I think going... This is exactly how VG Gaming lost game one. They had three cores with no team fight and no initiation kind of presence. And that's what IG have done here in game two. They went Weaver, Prophet, Invoker. The only way you have any team fight there really is if Invoker goes Quaz-Wex. Yes, Exo Invoker has some teamfight damage, but there's no like crowd control and there's no initiation from Exo Invoker.
Vici had the Sand Cane, but that was squishy initiation. This game, Vici has Doom, Alk, and Lifestealer. They have tanky initiation. Yep. And tanky initiation, like the Centaur last game, just can't be stopped.
No. I think IG have made a drafting mistake that Vici did in game one, so we'll see if
the Lane Sage could have gone better for them, though. They got pretty unlucky there.
Oh, Invis Rune Fire. Oh, Shadowblade from RTK. Chuan's going super aggressive here in the jungle.
This is not a good fight. Goodbye, Chuan.
They may get FY and Necrobooks a Burrow Strike to the high ground.
Chuan trying to retreat out here. They will find one hero on the high ground. They bring down him, but Chuan gets the Doom. RTK says, I'm getting something out of this fight, but that's not a bad trade for IG.
Yeah.
Poor Chuan.
Nowhere to go. That was just really aggressive from Chuan. But with Necro 3s, like Sand King is actually pretty tough. It's pretty tough to play against the Necro 3s and Sunstrike.
And the Forge Spirits, just constantly preventing his blink and...
He was smart. He Burrow Strike to the high ground, says, well, they can't follow me up here and you've got no vision up here, but that's where Sunstrike found him.
Not fun. It's a one for one. Definitely a good trade for IG given the circumstances, but Vici's still leading the way with all three cores topping the net worth chart and ready to go for some more engagements.
Oh, Silas coming with a flank. He's finished an Abyssal Blade now, and this is, I think, YYF insta-dead.
See you, YYF. Up towards the face. The Abyssal Blade popped as well. Maybe just a tiny bit early, but it won't matter. That's an easy kill.
Yeah.
Any three of their cores can kill any three of the other IG cores, I would say. IG need to throw four or five heroes to bring down a Doom, an Alk, or a Lifestealer at this point.
Yeah, and this is just getting scary and scary as Vici Gaming get more and more farmed here.
Vici are not playing that well right now. Like, they're playing pretty sloppy, getting picked off a lot. IG are moving well, but if Vici have one good team fight, that's just a team wipe with ease.
Well, we'll see. Doom finish off his Shiver's Guard, so there's the big next item we're talking about, which makes him a whole lot tankier and scarier. Super, he's got 1500, so Assault Crest not that close for him, but I imagine it will be his next item, unless Doom wants to go AC plus Shivers and then Alchemist goes like Basher or whatever it may be.
I wouldn't mind that. Doom already is hitting pretty damn hard with Alpha Wolf, Phase Boots, Shadow Blade.
Yeah, he could go like a Heart of Trask is the other option, but...
That wouldn't be bad. There's quite a bit of nuke damage in IG. I don't know that the item selections matter too much.
No.
Vici have already hit critical mass. It's just about not throwing, basically. Yeah. Like I'd say the only way they lose is with an aggressive throw.
Yeah. You just buy whatever big tier 4 item that you can think of, and you'll be doing just fine. You could buy a Dagon 5 if you really wanted.
Well, they're farming Ford Spirits now. Getting every bit of gold they can.
And Necrobooks.
Until denied.
Necrobooks not bad. The dice and VG Gaming, they've still got wards up pretty offensively, like in the near the Ancients, at top lane a bit. They have to be careful with their warding just because the Necro 3s are constantly dewarding them, but they're doing a pretty good job with it.
Gods, I think it's a good thing you withheld that tweet. I won't put you on blast here, but might have been a premature tweet had you gone for it.
It's a 3-game series, man.
I'm not saying it won't turn out to be right, but it would have been premature with how
I believe in my boy is all I'm going to say. And
yes, we all know who your boy is. We've outed you now.
I don't think he's done anything wrong this game.
No, I don't think so either. He's just food against this lineup with the way the game started. Yep. Here comes RTK on the bottom side, and that's a free kill.
Yeah. Use a Doom, why not? It's a 100-second cooldown. You're not team fighting or pushing anytime that soon, so
He bought a Shadow Blade first. Didn't lose any gold, just lost some honor.
Yeah.
Epicenter mid, now they're going for Chuan. It's two down.
Doesn't even come out of
this
the infest.
This is fish in a barrel for VG.
I love how the lifesteal stays inside because he wasn't needed. So now if they find Ferrari here in the jungle, he's donezo as well, and it looks like he will get caught.
Oh, they've still got the infest pop out that you mentioned. 430 has a four step, doesn't even get it off. The Abyssal Blade's there. Three just surgical kills from Vici. They're so easy to get these kills, too.
Lua's, I mean...
It's a Weaver split pushing. Even he's denied.
Yeah.
Nothing for you. Absolutely. And they've seen Faith now,
a worthy
too.
Effort at top.
They have Ancient Apparitional. They can go in on this Dazzle here. Ah, they'll go for it now. Blink onto the high ground. Burrow strike through. It's going to be 4-10. IG just getting ripped to shreds.
They can leave him to die to the Ice Blast if they want. And it looks like they'll do just that. Why waste time when you can be right-clicking the tower chasing down an already dead Dazzle?
Why does he explode in a clot of blood when he dies to Ice Blast? That doesn't make much sense. Shouldn't the blood be frozen?
Asking the tough questions,
everywhere.
LD.
My dote... Okay. Brian's saying the inner core hasn't frozen yet.
Okay.
Brian trying to be a smartass here.
Well, once again, YYF doing his TP warding, but
it felt a little more useful earlier, but now it's like, what does it matter?
Yeah.
Can't leave the base.
It may find them like a... It's allowing Luo to constantly split push top lane safely. That's the one bonus it gets. Because otherwise Luo has to be really scared of a Doom Shadow blading in and dooming him. But less so because of that ward.
It's just such a hard game to try to play Rat Dota.
Oh, yeah.
Last game, Rat Dota was actually fairly effective. It's just that they couldn't win the engages, but... And they couldn't use the Rat Dota to win the game, but this game, Rat Dota is no good.
It's not going to win you, like you say, it's not going to win you the game. It'll drag the game, but I just don't see IG having any way to win this game.
They don't have a lone druid who's farm. They're not breaking base that quickly.
We haven't had it. We've had one series, I think, go to three games. That was the HTT versus New Element, I think, when the game one was lost with the solo mid Coddle, and then they won game 2 and 3.
In the whole summit, Asia
yeah,
so far?
I think this could be our second series to go to a full three games.
It would take a pretty monumental throw to lose this one. Well, they'll go for a pick off top. They found Fenrir here, and the Sunstrike comes in nice engage from IG. Killing a hero under tower. They'll force out a TP, but FY's ready. He's found FY, or he's found YYF here with the epicenter. Is there any follow up to bring him down? Ah, he barely makes it out. Nice.
Yeah.
I thought they had two TPs. Oh, was Luo Doom TPing that whole time? Or
Luo in trouble at top.
Level death. Oh, no Doom. Okay. No, whole time lapse.
He knew it was coming too. I guess he saw Doom Shadowblade.
They do have a Prophet TP available as well. They could go for another kill.
On the Sand
King if he's stuck around
top. Yeah, Sand King. I guess, you Prophet TP, combine it with the Sunstrikes. But FY, not quite up to his BKB just yet.
Also some gold yet to be spent here on Vici. 5k on Sylar. Doom's going Refresher.
Yeah, why not? Is.
Does he have... he's got Shivas. Yeah, he's got the mana for it.
Yeah.
Well, it's just like a press-button win game for Vici. As long as they don't just keep on getting picked off.
Yeah, the items IG are getting just aren't scary. Like, Weaver's going to have a BKB following the Lincolns. YYF is maybe going to farm another damage item after his Shadowblade Orchid. Like, I think maybe you could just go, like, Daedalus and just hope for the best, but... Like,
he's just
Mjolnir,
such food.
Maybe.
He's such food. He gets doomed, he's dead. He gets abyssal, he's dead. He gets Alk stunned or impale or Burrow strike, he's dead.
You still got a max Exort Invoker, so he does have a lot of killing power with his Chaos Media combo.
True,
but
less so when there's quadruple magic immunity, which there is now with FY picking up a BKB, three BKBs, and the rage. Exort Invoker still has good right click. He is a good mix of damage, but I don't know if it's enough alone. I'm not high on IG's chances right now, gods.
No, me neither.
I would not be placing keys. I would not be doubling down right now on my bet for this game. Maybe for the series. I think they've looked fine in the series. Oh, yeah. Just not so much this game.
You'd have to give me some crazy, crazy odds, and I don't know. Even then, I'd just be like, nope, not happening. But they can drag this game. That's the thing. Like, if they can drag this game 30 plus minutes,
he's already trying to TP.
Oh
here.
Gosh,
Admiral Bulldog would be proud.
Oh, he may see the career. He may get a career snipe, which is not really game changing. But hey,
has phase boots. That's some gold that RTK would like in his pocket.
Well, yeah. I mean,
oh, they see YYF though.
Trouble.
They might catch him TPing for the courier. Oh no! YYF.
He sees the career.
They found Chuan. Yeah, they'll settle for Chuan instead.
Any TP in the base for the courier? No. At this point, IG's game plan, I think, as far as any chance to win this game, is drag this game 60-plus minutes.
And now Faith. It's another kill. Yep. Yeah, they got to drag it, like you said, 50, 60, 70 minutes.
Yeah. get to the point where Weaver can actually get, like, right now, Avicii Gaming, almost all their heroes are six slotted. Like, okay, Doom's not quite there, Alchemist's not quite there, but they're very close. But IG are still maybe a third or halfway to six slotted. So if IG can actually get their three core heroes six slotted, then hey, they fight on equal terms. But VG Gaming, they're mid lane, they're ready to end this.
They can go high ground, I think, now. They have AC, the lanes aren't actually that pushed in. 430 will try and stall this. Icefall, very effective against the quad melee draft. Actually, Invoker, pretty effective there in general. Power dropping fairly low. Sylar may have to use an Infest soon, and he will do so, but gets the HP heal. The lane pushing in top. Not fast enough for YYF. Doesn't have a Desolator, doesn't have a Necro Book. His split push isn't really that scary. This could be the win for VG. As long as they don't overextend, they should get a lane of Rex out of this.
Yeah, even with IG have 5 alive, that's the really crazy thing. It's like, oh, they can't defend and they've got 5 alive. They are split pushing top lane with Prophet. We're going to go down as well. Luo gets her out without getting doomed or brought down to start things off, but there's your Axis.
Yeah, Impale connects on too. Still the BKBs are available. The meatball comes through. Sylar, he's running out. He still has Aegis. He'll be mech'd up. Sunstrike, not going to connect on him.
Still nice. Like, Sylar getting this low means you either have to just go for the Raxes and use the Aegis, or you have to back off for a little bit.
They forced RTK out, but there's still quite a bit of time left on Aegis.
Yeah.
They don't have to go now.
Doom's top there. This is end of the push. They're not going to go high ground without the Doom, so Vici Gaming decide.
They force out Glyph, they take Rex staff,
they're
they
gonna
get a tier 3.
Though.
Not bad.
They got vision for this.
Oh, fun. That's a two-hero burrow from FY. Then there's a stun over the top. The epicenter just to celebrate. That's two dead. Now they probably go high ground. Courier will pick up the gem. Good little bit of micro here from IG.
Yeah. And even with Doom at top lane, his boots will travel up in 20 seconds, so they'll maybe wait for that and then once again try that high ground push. Are you? Oh, no, that's just me lagging. Phew. For a second, I thought it was...
Internet, have mercy.
No, it's the good old Perfect World server bite.
Yeah, not the Verizon fail, which we've been countering a few times recently, but not too much fortunately. And it seems the restart has fixed it.
Well, IG, pop the ice ball as Sylar just goes raging through that one. So not going to get slowed at all, and this is going to be Raxus down with no glyph. So
they have to give this.
He infest dodges the EMP. That's actually really smart. He's got no mana, so it's actually well worthwhile to do.
Yeah, he would have none if he didn't infest dodge.
I kind of like that play.
Infest has a decent cooldown, but saves the Aegis.
He's got Aegis, so it's like Infest is there to maybe save his life, but he doesn't need it when he's got Aegis.
There's a silence on Sylar. There's actually no Doom for this fight. He's off bottom lane.
BKB being used really early from Luo. I think like the Alchemist stun was coming in. He did have the Lincoln still, though.
FY wants to re-engage. They have the Doom joining the fight. They'll have 5 alive. And that mid... just annoying play from IG.
5 Alive sounds like it could be a good band name.
It is a good name. I came up with it.
Yeah. What kind of genre is your band?
I don't have a band.
We were on Facebook yesterday after the cast finding a Beyond the Summit theme band.
They're metalcore. Brian's like, I bet there's going to be a guy screaming with lots of guitars.
Spot on,
the
man.
Genre says metalcore. Brilliant deduction, K-Poptosis.
Well, there was Beyond the Summit, which is a band. I don't know what genre they are. We didn't check it out. We checked out Beyond the Summer. They were a good metalcore band.
Yeah.
Yeah. They had some good music, man. Brian was a fan. He was into that.
Brian was all about it. Tron, no. Not long for this world. RTK, we'll give him the right clicks.
He may need some metalcore music to get him
he's
through
gonna
this
it
game.
Well.
Oh, he dodges!
He dodges.
Yeah, he dodges. He's doomed, so the doom damage is found in that case. Okay.
They are trading here, but FY comes in. He unwinds the epicenter and brings down one. Super cleaning up the swarm, and the Weaver forced to beat a hasty retreat.
Oh, bottom lane, that's a bit of a retreat here. They've got the refresher, so if Doom wants to turn around and pop a second Doom...
he's got Shivas. He can drop 2 Shivas here. He'll Doom my way. Surprise, motherfucker!
Oh, what's Tron gonna do? He's got a Finger of Death here, but RTK's BKB goes for the deny. Tron says, screw you, YYF.
Big plays. We'll get RTK. That could be a gem down as well.
RTK? Well, he's still alive.
He's apparition ult in 2 seconds, though. See ya, Tron. Oh, peace. Then they don't get
GG.
RTK either.
That's it. That's game. That was we had a. It was a fun way to end the game. Like, I feel like this game, like we talked about. VG Gaming had this game won for a long, long time, but I'm glad we got to hang around for that ending, because that was a lot of fun, the last 5 minutes.
Just for a little
game.
Extra blood.
Yeah.
Some destruction. Annihilation.
Yeah.
Headed to a game 3. It's been 2 fairly one-sided games so far, this one especially.
Yes. Yeah.
I just go back to the laning, and I liked the way VG moved around. They didn't let IG get the easy 5 ranged heroes against 4 melee, city and lanes. They just dodged the ganks, they got the lucky haste rune, their movement was great.
These teams, I think, you can't bank so much on the laning stage. You need to have that plan B if your laning stage doesn't work out, which is, like, have a solid mid-game team fight. Like, that's where, and I think that's where we're seeing Sentinel get banned in Game 2. I think Game 3 we'll see Sentinel probably banned again, because it's, like, you pick center, it's, it fits any game as an offlane hero. It's also really good because you can safe lane solo center. It's one of the, it's surprisingly good in 1v1 matchups, so I think center is going to be the key hero in Game 3. If it's not banned out, it's going to be, like, first pick material.
That hero's legit.
Because team with the better team fight has just been winning these games, not the better laning stage.
Yeah, that's generally been the case. Also, tanky initiators seem to be very strong, and Centaur definitely the king of those. Yeah. So.
Two games in a row, offensive tri lane fails as well. So Chinese team's not known for their offensive tri laning ability, though.
And this patch not known for it in general.
Yeah.
So, with that being said, guys, you're watching The Summit, powered by Twitch. We've just clipped $105,000. Thanks to your support. Thanks for that. Keep it up if you're interested. The bundle is available in the store for $9.99. It comes with an X set, as well as, of course, your Dota TV ticket. And we'll have stretch goals to be announced very soon. I'm LD. He's Gods. And we're joined here by the ever-so-slacking K-Pop-tosis. I'm just firing all the shots.
Can we have some Beyond the Summer during the break?
Beyond the Summer?
Do we have Beyond the Summer
Let's
on your
Let's get a
playlist?
Little metalcore here. Okay. Oh no.
We can talk for days.
The casters have to stay on camera. Ooh.
So we're being punished, LD. We're being punished.
Yeah. That's going to wrap up game 2. We'll be back for game 3. He's not moving.